right here. We got the mother and stepfather of the bride, Marcia and Barone Brown. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the besties, the best man and the maid of honor for the evening. We have here Kimberly and Alex.
Blood, and she said she gon' do what a hoop. Yes, by now.
Let's all grab our seats and get ready for the next portion of the evening. I know it's like, you know what? These people know how to feed me. They know exactly where to feed us on time. Let's just grab our seats real quickly. I promise you, the bride and the groom will be coming around at each table this evening. Thank you, thank you. So I'm going to call on Pastor Milton at this time to lead us into grace and bless our food as we begin our evening.
All right, let's bow our heads as we're going to pray. All right, let us pray. Our Lord, my God, Father, we thank you for this another night, O God. Father, we come tonight. Oh Lord, Father, I pray that you bless me with this food. I pray that you bless the hands of one that made it. Bless the hands of the one that did the provision. Give the money out to prepare the food. Bless the preparer, sanctify it, and bless it, and let it be nourished to our bodies. Oh Lord, amen.
Amen.
Thank you. So let me ask you, do we all know what this means?
Yes.
Yes. All right, so I'm looking at your Latin mat tonight. So as we're serving our meal, I'd like to take 2 minutes because, you know, we would all like to say something wonderful about Alicia and Daniel, but what we're going to do is give the individuals that will not be speakers tonight about 2 to 3 minutes. Each person will have about 30 seconds to give me a word that describes either one. So, I'm going to take about 5 people just to give me a word that you think embodies that individual. And we're going to start with the nephew over here.
My word would have to be off. I'm off. How are you doing? Hello, cousin Daniel.
Hi, off.
My word would have to be irresistible. Because I like the way you all play off of each other. There's not too many people who have the laughter that you all do. I really appreciate that. And I like that. I really love how Alicia has accepted Dominic. It means a lot the way the families have been coming together. It means a lot to me.
Do I have a volunteer next? Anyone?
I'll talk.
Oh. Hi, y'all. My name is Raquel. I'm Alicia's cousin.
Hello.
Calling from New York. I'm going to talk for 2 seconds. Alicia is a firecracker. I can't believe she's married right now. But she actually found somebody to match her. You guys are both Pisces, right?
No.
No? What are you doing?
Oh, my God.
Well, I can tell they matched because they came to my house in New York and I can just see the look on their eyes and they're always in their own world, I can tell. And I'm just happy for the both of them and I pray that you guys have a long-lasting marriage and I'm so excited for everything that you guys are gonna do in the future. Please keep me involved. You're gonna be in the U.S. now, right?
Virginia for now.
Okay, Virginia. I didn't want to put you on blast. I wasn't sure if you didn't want anybody to know, but she's going to be in Virginia, and you better text me and send me pictures and all that crazy stuff when you get your family dog, you know. But congratulations, guys. I love you both. Daniel, welcome to the family. And I'm excited for all the future endeavors for the both of you. God bless both of you.
So, no one wants to share, huh? I'm going to start picking out my own volunteers right here.
Chris!
I'm always talking, so Sparky picks me. But
10 seconds.
So I'm dance with one of the bigger brothers. What I'm saying is endurance. That's what I would like to make you understand and hopefully keep that in mind, endurance. I see the love you have and the longevity you have and potential. So endurance will be the key. God bless you both.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hello, Alicia and your husband. I wish you both such wonderful blessings. I'm Natasha.
Hi.
I'm representing the family from England. Kevin and John, I wish you all the best. And always remember, never go to bed on an argument. And turn the argument into a passion. Alright? And all the best, alright? Love you.
Now I know one other person in the room through my observation that was more passionate about this wedding other than Alicia's mother. Now we're going to move on to the other gentleman of the night.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Donnie.
Forgive me, I got salad in my mouth. I just want to say that when I opened the door and I saw Alicia that day, and Danny walked right by me, he said, just like this, hey, what's up, bro? This is my fiance. He didn't call first. He didn't send a text. No letters or nothing. Lisa came in. She sat down at the kitchen table. Her hair was messed up. She had a sweatsuit. But my mom, his mom, Jane, she said, that's the one for him. And we'll always stand behind him. I want everybody to hear that clapping. Put some money in the box and make sure you stand behind them too. One more thing. Our brother's not here, but if he was, he'd be happy too.
I couldn't have done a better job. Thanks, Dolly.
Do we have anyone else?
Ooh! We are the Bryant sisters. Well, I'm going to speak for myself first. Alicia is my niece. I can see her very much today. And the last few days I've seen her. I am so proud. I am so glad. She's just what I expected. Beautiful. Coming from this family, I knew she would be beautiful. But she's also bright. And I'm so glad to have met her husband. I was worried. But once I saw it, I'm no longer worried. She'll be alright. All I'm saying to Alicia and her husband, look after each other. I'm not going to say he to look after you alone. It takes two. And I know you will, Lisa, so it's up to him now. We'll be right behind you. So he better will.
Okay, hi, I am Alicia's auntie, and just want to thank you, Alicia, for sharing this precious moment. We are wishing you the best. We want you to protect this love between you and Daniel. Just like we have been advised when a hurricane's coming that we have to protect our homes, you've got to protect that love. And all of us in this room are rooting for you, and we just want to, again, thank you for sharing this special moment. Thank you.
Alicia, I'm speaking here on behalf of my brother,
your father. He loves you. He cried today. He tears of joy. When Daniel gave us that speech, we both cried. It was beautiful. Daniel, I didn't meet you before, but I fell in love with you today. Take care of my niece. Okay. Thank you.
All right, we got the last two. Now we're gonna move into the actual ones for the evening that were on the agenda.
Good evening. Hello, my name is Ricardo. I am Alicia's cousin, not by blood, but as you know, with Caribbean families, you know, everyone is considered family if you truly have that bond. And so my word for Alicia is competitive. I remember growing up with her playing video games all the time, and she was very, very good at beating me amongst other people. So my sentiment exactly, but with that I would like to say, with that same fighting spirit, never forget, always fight for each other. No matter how hard times get, how good things are, remember, always fight for each other and keep that love. So from my family to you, thank you.
Literally, my other half, Daniel, sorry. Because I've known this girl for most of my life, and there's not a moment that goes by, even when you're off. I think I cried the hardest when you left. Like, I do not, I want to go with you. I didn't want to get emotional, but I just want to say thank you for being a part of my life. And I'm so proud of the person that you've grown into. And if I had to describe you in one word, it would be genuine. There's nobody in this world like Alicia Bryant. And there never will be. Nobody can replace her. And Daniel, treat my sister well. Treat her well, because I've never seen her care for somebody the way she cares for you. And I almost think she loves you more than me. And that's a lot of love. So I wish you all nothing but the best. And if I had to give you any advice, whatever happens between you two, keep it between you two. Because when people get in your business, opinions form and judgment change. So I'm married, so I have experience. So put your husband first, put your wife first,
yes.
And never forget who your priority is besides that little boy there. Yeah. I love you both and I wish you well.
Wonderful.
Alright, so we have one more, and that's going to be me. My word is innovator. I really believe Alicia is an innovator because she went to school, she studied one thing. She came out, she went into her field, and she said, hold up, this really isn't me. She talked to her mom about it, and her mom was like, why don't you become a nurse? That's when the phone came up, called me. I don't want to be a nurse, but she wants me to be. I said, you know what? I think you need to go to the military. And I'm not gonna cry. The reason why I said that was she had a passion for recognizing who people were. And I felt like her path in the military would allow her to be a profiler in her future. But instead of becoming a profiler, she was able to find her stalker. And I actually preferred that. And I truly appreciate you, Daniel, because let me tell you, I could truly believe you are the one, especially when she thought you were drowning. I did hear. You made her heart come through her mouth, right? All right, so we're gonna start off with my They say he's my brother, but I'm not quite sure. Sheldon?
Hey. Alright. I am glad to meet you, though, right? I like talking. But listen, I already spoke to Daniel. I said, keep my sister safe, keep her happy. Alicia's already happy, she's smiling. I'm happy for that. Anytime y'all need me, just call me. I'll be there. Alright? That's it. Let's be good. Thank you.
Sheldon is truly our bodyguard. He is the Knights Round Table all by himself for his sisters, and we truly love him for that. He's also our bank account. So, we got these two special people over here that's gonna wrap up our wonderful evening in this area. And we're gonna start right here.
I know that your dad is proud of you, and he's looking up above this baby girl, and he is so proud of you, okay? For those of you who may not know who I am, my name is Kimberly, and I'm honored to be Alicia's cousin. And I'd like to thank everyone for joining us for the union of Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Bethea. For the individuals who may not know Alicia personally, she's the most outgoing, effervescent, charismatic, and selfless person I know. And because of this, this has gotten her in trouble numerous times. We have shared great memories together. For example, the time when she unintentionally tried to kill me. However, she has also resuscitated me. But hey, that's what cousins are for. Cousins are connected heart to heart. Distance and time can't take them, can't tear us apart. The day I found out that you were leaving to go to Japan, I was devastated. Because not only did I lose my cousin, but I lost my sister, and I lost my best friend. The calls become less frequent, and the visits were shorter. Nevertheless, I was happy for you. Because deep down inside, I knew you had a lifetime of memories that you shared in Japan, and you also found a soulmate. Daniel, I will never forget the day I met you, because on that day, you decided that you wanted to be a part of our family. I was honored when you asked me to orchestrate your engagement to my cousin, which was on Memorial Day. A day that can be never forgotten. Good luck trying to remember September 23rd. The both of you define soulmates, friends, confidants, unconditional love, and reciprocal regards. And I just have a few advice for you guys. Keep God first in all you do. Never. Let me repeat that. Never fall asleep upset at each other. Daniel, always put the toilet seat down. And never question her with a pair of situation that she would like to buy.
Exactly.
And the most important, Proverbs chapter 18, verse 22. Who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor of the Lord.
Amen.
Now, Daniel and Alicia, take a look around the room. This is everyone that loves and supports you. And the both of you will never be alone. I love you both and congratulations.
That was beautiful, Kimberly. Thank you so much. Now we got the other bestie over here.
That's a good makeup. Check it out. Good evening, afternoon, everyone. How are you doing? How's everybody doing? Are you doing good? I heard the food is good. It's going to be delicious. Before I begin my tribute to Little Brother, I first want to give honor to God and all that are here and those that are not here, which are Derek, his little brother, and Donnie, the baby, his father, both of which have gone on to glory before us, both of which were great people, especially all of them. Now, I met this young man and another little young man, 5 years younger, named Derek, together on Marion Street. Marion Street is where his family lives. That's their home, just so you know.
Marion Street.
She said Marion Street. Everybody give up for Marion Street. Marion Street. Marion Street. That's it. Marion Street. Daniel and Derek were the most interesting, charming, friendly little men I have ever met. They were the greatest. I fell in love with them as little brothers the second I met them. That's who I am. Now, my extended family, which is the Taylor family, we met Mom, Vita, Donnie, and Tracy. They're here for us tonight. They're all the family. This one right here is a rebel. We love the rebels, because the rebels always do things, but then it always turns out great. You can't imagine all the things this dude did, but ended up doing the right thing. How'd that happen? He's a good guy. He's a really good guy. There's absolutely nothing in this world less than illegal that I would not do for my children and my little brother Daniel. And then a few other people too. I won't name them. So, Daniel, Dominic, and Lovely. This is Lovely. Wait, did y'all see Lovely? This is Lovely. This is my nickname for her. The second I met her, I called her Lovely, and I've been calling her that ever since. You both know that any phone call I get from you will be answered. Anything that you need that I have, you will have. Anything that you want that I can get, you will get. I will always love you. There's nothing you can do that's going to make me turn away from you, because you never turned away from me, okay? Our entire family loves you. I love you more than I can say, and I'm saying goodnight to my mom.
Thank you. As your dinner is coming up. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that tonight. I just want to go over a few housekeeping items as we continue the night. At the beginning of the night, I ask respectfully on behalf of the newlyweds for us not to do any postings on social media out of respect for the newlyweds until they have had an opportunity to do their announcement themselves. We would like that, please and thank you. Now, for the part that I've been waiting for, I'm nosy, I don't know about you guys, but I heard a little bit of the story, but I really want to hear a little bit more. How did Daniel, how did you become a stalker?
So we were both based in Japan on the same ship, and I wasn't aware, I had never seen her before. But when I first seen her, I literally had to stop and, you know, and just almost like stare. I'm happy she didn't catch me staring, but I really had to stop in my tracks. And she just had this smile on her face, you know, just walking about her business. And I found it so amazing. And I started to ask, you know, one of the guys, I think it was Fernandez, Brian. I asked him, I was like, who is that? I'm like, oh, that's just NBA Street Brian. I was like, what's her story? Like, I don't know. He's like, I've been here just as long as you have. You know, so, you know, I just kept watching her, you know, whenever I got the chance to even just say hello, you know, how you doing, ABH3? And she'd give me this look like, hi, like, who is this person talking to me? You know, and I would do that, you know, every day until I got the chance to, you know, see her. We were at a club that was on base as well, and I walked up to her and I asked her, so what's your name? So she goes, ABH3 Bryant. And I said, okay, what's your first name? She said, I'm not telling you. And I was like, well, why? She says, because I don't know you like that. You know, so that made me attracted to her even more, you know. And, you know, I had to find out once, you know, one thing about me is like, you tell me I can't have it, I'm going to go at it even harder. You know, so it was a couple other instances where she was, you know, walking through a parking lot after a party, and I was, you know, I was like, okay, maybe this is my opportunity to, you know, walk her home. You know, so I'm like, hey, where you going? She goes, so she goes, I'm going to the bathroom. Now, even as a stalker, I know you can't go with a woman to the bathroom. So I go, okay, have a good night, you know, and I let her go. And we were both doing some volunteer work, and she was coming to me to ask me some information because I was one of the main facilitators of it, you know, and she was asking me information. I saw this as another opportunity to talk to her again, you know, so I tried to drag out the conversation. So she's like, hey, where's the event? And I'm like, why do you want to know where the event is? And so, like, and she just like snapped on, you're gonna tell me what the event is or not? I don't have time to play games with you. Okay, the event's gonna be here, you know. She's like, thank you. She just walked away, you know. So after that, we met at the event. And I told, you know, hey, I like you. I have feelings for you. And she laughed in my face. So after so many times of trying, you know, and having someone laugh in your face, you know, like, you know what? I'm done. So, you know, she stopped like, no, it's not like that, you know, I laugh when I'm nervous. So I'm like, oh, okay, all right, I'm glad you clarified that, because I was about to be done. But ever since then, you know, we were friends, we became good friends, and we became lovers and husband and wife now. So that's what I've ever done. Love you.
Now, you know they say that. Now, they always say there's three sides to a story, right? So that was his side of the story. How truthful did that sound? I think he left out a few different embarrassing moments there that he didn't want to share. So we're going to hear the bride's side of the story, and we're going to match it up and see if it actually is correct.
Good evening, everyone. So my first interaction with Daniel was, hi, ABH3. And I'm just like, who are you and why do you know my name? Then I looked down and I remembered it was on my uniform. Right? But every single time I walked into a room, I just feel eyes piercing through me. And it was him. It creeped me out quite a bit because I'm like, why are you always looking at me? Because, you know, I don't put two and two together. Maybe a guy's looking at me because he likes me. I just thought he was looking at me because he was weird or crazy. One of the two. And neither of them was favorable for me. Right? But it wasn't until the volunteer event where I had to speak to him. Because if I didn't have to speak to him, I would have never spoke to him. Right? I had to speak to him. I got lost. And I'm super cheap. Very, very frugal.
Yes.
So, I never did want to pay for the Japanese phone that had the GPS that can get you to your exact location. So I did have this little flip phone. It was hot pink. It was super cute. But and waterproof, by the way. Waterproof. But it was this little Japanese flip phone. And I decided to say, you know, instead of following the directions he gave me the first time, I'm going to go off on my own tangent. And I got lost up in the Japanese housing complex. I don't know how I got there, but I wasn't supposed to be there. So I'm lucky I didn't get arrested. All right? So before I even had the opportunity to call him, he actually came looking for me. And he found me at a stop sign, freaking out and lost. And he's just like, come on, I'll take you to where you need to be. He took me there, he got me checked in, he showed me around exactly what it was I was supposed to do, and then he told me that he had liked me after the event was done, and I didn't know what to do with myself, so I started laughing. He's just like, oh yeah, you know, I think you're attractive and so on and so forth. I'm just like, oh, that's what that was. You know, so since then it's like, him and I have been like bati and chief, right? Bati and job. We've been together. And it never been more apparent since one of my relatives had passed away, right? It was during the holiday Christmas party. My mom had just told me one of my younger cousins had passed in an unfortunate car accident coming back from university. So what he did was, he made sure I got home, and we violated the rules, and he stayed with me the entire night. And I sat there in bed, bawling my eyes out. Because my little cousin passed away too soon. And he was there for me. And he kept me calm. Even though it would have caused him to get kicked out of the military or caused his boat to get kicked out, but I really needed somebody and he was there for me. So from then, him and I have been just inseparable. You know, like, he partakes in my joy, and he partakes in my sadness, and I'm so happy to have found somebody that I can really open up to and be myself around. I'm just so happy to be with him. I'm so happy to be with him. Thank you everybody for coming and, you know, enjoying your time with us. So, moving forward, just a couple of housekeeping. If you have an envelope or anything of that nature that you would like to drop off for the newlyweds, this is your box right here. During dinner, after they've eaten, they will be stopping at each table to say hi. And right before dinner ends, we're going to go ahead and do a cake cutting ceremony. Okay? And that will give you guys an opportunity to get a little more personal. So please feel free.
Stop by. I'm going to go to the next one. 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 I'm going to go to the next one
look familiar. I said, nah, you don't know me.
Thank you.
Away. And I know she will you know, continue to strive in this wonderful and magnificent way. But, you know, she's just involved in, to something today, which is one of the sacraments of marriage, which is not an easy thing. And I want to encourage her that there's going to be a lot of obstacles in the way, but be true to yourself, be true to your husband, and by all means, listen to your husband, not to your mother, not to your best friend, who always has the best advice for you. At the end of the day, you guys are one. And whatever decision is made, let it be you, both of you. So if it goes bad, you can blame yourself. I'm not even gonna help. Okay? That's all I'm gonna say about that. But I wanna just touch on the numerous achievements that Marie has achieved over the years. You know, and I put myself by, you know, high school. She made the track, of course. And at the college days, oh boy. The dancing stuff, the costumes. I was in the day with these things on Facebook and you know, MySpace band, you know, showing her costumes and but it was all good. She went through those phases and it's a rite of passage. But the important thing is she persevered and she graduated and then things wasn't going the way she wanted to be. So she looked for something else. She thought about being a naval personnel. I'd rather go to the Air Force, but that's a whole other question. Their wings are made of lead, or what's made of gold, but it's okay. I won't hold it against you, Alice. Yeah, that's okay. Anyway, I just want to encourage you guys to continue doing your best. You know, and I'm always, you know, in some selfish way, I miss your call, asking you about everything from her headache to her costume. You know, and it's a touch where I miss that. However, I'm happy to matriculate to this wonderful, independent, strong, phenomenal woman she is today. And Danielle, you have got a wonderful wife, a strong wife, and with both of you, that's twofold, so please work together and continue this wonderful, happy tradition that you started today. Please be true to each other, be loving to each other, love each other, care for each other. In conclusion, I just want to say, you know, I'm proud of you guys. I'm just happy. And I wish your dad was here to see us today. You know, he's not here in physical, but I'm sure he's here in spirit and he's ready from ear to ear. So he's watching over you guys, and I'm always going to be here for you guys. So don't hesitate to call me. I can't sound everything, and I know I'll be a shoulder for you crying if that needs to be. So please. No, that you have somebody here for me. Happy to see you both. And big up, yes? Alright.
Love.
and her uncle to make the stage.
Yeah.
four couples.
Say this, cool, my dear, poverty, poverty. Yeah.